And now, more with Social Women, with your hosts, Pat Cruz, Amy Diaz, and Bronwyn Dannenfeltzer.
We are with Dr. Melanie St. Jean of Johnson & Wales University, and we're going to talk a little bit about higher education, lipstick economies, and a lot of other neat stuff.
That's right.
Especially as we're ready to go into 2012, and you know what we can put on our radar screen. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a professor at Johnson & Wales University in the College of Business Department of Marketing, and I specialize in retail and apparel courses.
Nice. I love that. Everyone just lit up a little bit here, like, really?
Very fortunate to be teaching retail classes.
That's such a neat thing. And so is it undergraduate or graduate?
Right now it's an undergraduate program, but we are looking to expand into a graduate program or a graduate concentration in the near future.
Very nice. We were mentioning interns because Pat was saying that you are an incredible matchmaker when it comes to kind of, you know, setting Pat up with like incredible marketing interns.
I have to say, I don't mean to break in on you. Melanie and I go back a little ways, just a bit, and we connected through Facebook.
We did,
and she has been getting me the most amazing interns all since we started with. I think I was doing the bridal show, Into the Woman show, and the magazine, and the networking events, and every time she has been spot on with the perfect interns, and I'm so grateful. So every time she sends someone over to me, I don't even have to think twice about it. I know they're just going to be right for the job. That's which I think is a great thing through Johnson & Wales, because they actually do go through and choose the right people that are going into the positions for internship.
That is true. We have an experiential education program where all of our students have to do either one or two internships before they graduate. We are known as an experiential university, so we really focus on academics, but we want the student to go in prepared and trained before they go into the workforce. And we are very good in our experiential education department. We have great people that work there, that we look at everybody's resumes, we look at what the students are interested in, we look at what the companies want and require, and we really try to match the right student with the right employer. It's the right fit, and you know, it works out for both companies, and we're so happy that it's worked out for you.
Yes, it has. Tremendously well.
So can you tell us a little bit about, so that's kind of the undergraduates and students. How about, what do you do for like continuing education?
We have a wonderful continuing education program, and in the last few years, we have had many concentrations: international marketing, hospitality, criminal justice. We just entered into a continuing education program. We're looking at going global with the global international program at Johnson & Wales University. And we've had great success for both males and females in the industry. We are seeing an increase in females coming back and getting MBA programs and then going on to get doctorate programs and PhDs also.
Wow. Does a bachelor's program kind of get you where you need to go these days, or do you really need a master's program?
You know, every company is different, but more companies are requiring that you do have an MBA program. And there are a lot of companies out there that will also supplement and help pay for the MBA program. It's, you know, it's an added bonus to your undergrad, but it's also allowing the woman who takes the MBA or gets the MBA to expand her knowledge in fields that are related to what she already knows.
It's funny. I don't think I've ever told anybody besides my husband this, but I've actually considered going back to school because my degree's in acting, which, you know, is kind of a strange thing. I ended up in development, but I always wondered if I should go back, learn a little bit more about marketing, which I'm just fascinated by marketing and communications. I love it. And the communications is like acting. But it's always looked a little, I don't know. I always go, do I have enough time? Or what's the average length of time to go back to school if I were to do it on a part-time basis and get a master's?
You know, every college is different, and every program will work with you. A lot of MBA programs, you can go on Friday nights and Saturdays. It would be a Friday night 4 hours and a Saturday 6 hours. So schools really want to work with you so that you can get an MBA program. Some students finish their MBA program in 2 years. Some take 4 or 5 years. It really depends on, you know, what you want to do, what time you have available to do it. So every college will work with you. And I tell my students this from day one. Knowledge is power. So the more knowledge that you have, the more powerful you are. And as a woman, with all women in this room, you know that, I mean, power... almost.
Larry. Except for Larry. Larry, we'll give you... we'll make you an honorary woman for the moment.
Okay.
But you know, it's not just power. Isn't just about you know, moving up in a company. Power is about knowledge and knowing and being able to speak with different people, people that you meet on the street, people that you meet in meetings. And when you do that and you have that knowledge, you'll be invited to do things like this. You'll be invited to speak to other students. You'll be invited to, you know, talk to other women. And I think, you know, as a community, as a female community, we need to do that. And women look to that. They look to other women as role models more than men do, and that's a proven fact. And you know, I've had role models, one-on-one role models, personal role models that, you know, that I work with daily, but I also have role models like Andrea Young, who is the CEO of Avon. I've never met her, but I followed her career and I looked at what she's done, and I try to emulate things that she's done to be successful, to make myself successful. So a mentor, you know, again, doesn't have to be somebody that you're sitting right next to and that you meet weekly. It can be somebody that you're following their career path and really emulate what they do and how they do it.
I love that.
I love that.
That's awesome. Can I just ask something really quickly? What about money? Like, how are you financing? Is there financing? Like, if I want to go back to school, is it a lot? I always think that kids coming out of high school have a better shot at financing an education.
Everybody has the ability to apply for some type of grant or financial aid, and a lot of schools have in-house financial aid, but also there are a lot of banks and a lot of federal institutions that you can go to and you can get financial assistance for.
Nice. Sorry, Pat, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, not at all. So, you know, you were just getting into women in mentorship, and there's a lot of that that's so important, because we women do really follow women, and there's many that I follow, and actually you are one of them, because
you
do so many great things with the students. And we were just talking a little bit before we came on. Tell me about lipstick economy. That's what I really want to know.
It's very interesting. This is something that came up a couple of months ago, that some of the consumer consensus bureaus and labor statistics are showing that there are more women in the workforce today than men. So the economy is being labeled as a lipstick economy. And at first I found that, you know, kind of amusing. Why not high heel economy? Why not pocketbook economy? But like the lipstick jungle, that's fine. But it is known as a lipstick economy. More women are progressing in the workforce in many areas, business, hospitality, medical. So we're making our ground, but again, we're doing that because in these industries there are strong women that have set that path for us, and we're looking to them and we're following them.
I think that's just amazing. Who would you consider a mentor that you've been following?
Oh, Pat. Besides large ones. Well, you know, I look to what Maria Shriver does, always what Oprah's doing. But there's so many. I like to watch the people that have come from just an average life, mm-hmm. and have built themselves up, and a lot through marketing and what they do. Not necessarily the money that they have, but what they've done for the community. That's what I like to look for.
And how about you, Amy?
I would have to say the same. For me, you know, Pat has always been a mentor of mine. A close mentor of mine is also Erica Cruz, who works at the Supreme Court here in Rhode Island. And again, for me, it's women that are doing amazing things with their time, with their money, with their power, with their influence, and just doing great positive things for the community, because that's what I hope to do one day, and that's what I strive to do every day. So those are the types of people. Oprah, of course. It's just like, who is it?
Melanie, you said that yours is the CEO of Avon. It's about anybody else.
That's an amazing one.
Yeah. There has actually one of my professors when I first went to college, Dorcas Green, is a mentor of mine, and she's somebody that we've stayed close in the last 30 years. But she's somebody that follows my career, that I look at her career. But just knowing that she's there and what she has done for colleges, what she's done for women in her business, I emulate that. I think it's a wonderful thing. But you're right, giving back to the community and, you know, being, you know, not selfish and letting everybody know what you can do and how you can do something. It's not just about the money. You're absolutely
right.
It's not.
And what I find the most is it's interesting because we're talking about women and it being a lipstick economy. But I find so many times women are not supportive of each other. We'll follow each other's career, but we won't provide tools for each other to succeed. So I can sit here and emulate what someone's doing, but sometimes I at least wish that I could get whatever tools it is that they have, or if something was available to me. I find that women are a little more competitive than men. There's more of a brotherhood with men where it's like, oh yeah, well I have this and I have that. With women, it's like, well, this is mine and this is how I got it. And unless you go through exactly what I did, there's no way for you to get it because I went through so many hardships. And for me, it's one of those things where this is what I did. I want to make your life easier. You want to succeed? Here you go. This is what I did. This is what I didn't do. This is what I learned from it. If you want to go ahead through the same path and make the same mistakes, go right ahead. Just know that there's an easier way for you to get to where you want to be without having to go through the struggle. So when it comes to adult continuing education, my number one advice is go back to school. You want to do something and you feel like that's what's going to get you, go. Don't try to go straight into the job force and start at a lower level position when you can go to school. Invest a couple of years and then go in at a higher position so that instead of you having to work your way up, you're working your way up in a different way where you're learning about yourself. You never even know. Maybe it's something that you don't even like. So
hold that thought.
I think that's
a great that kind of path of conversation. Also, like the nurturing versus competition. We'll continue chatting with Dr. Melanie St. Jean of Johnson & Wales on that nurturing versus competitive nature. I would love to have a little bit of your insight on that.
I find women to be helpful.
Yeah, that's because you're helpful.
I do. I find women to be very helpful with what they're going through. I try to, you know, maneuver people instead of going through the longer way to say, hey, you know what, try this. It might save you a couple of steps.
As your body grows big, your mind must flower. It's great to learn because knowledge is power.
So what do you have to say about that? What do you think?
I agree. I think there is a generation where women don't want to share. And I think it's because they had to fight with men for so long to get that equal position in the workforce. But today, our generation, we're willing to share that because we went through a lot of trials and tribulations. I know I did, especially in the retail field. I had to, compete with men. And, when women compete with men, we're looked at a little bit differently. And if I can make, my students' lives a little bit easier, saying this is what you have to do and how you have to do it, I'm all for that.
And that's why this one's for the girls. Thank you so much.
We just had a great conversation while we were off the air about continuing education and the difference between school experience and work experience.
Exactly. And, one of the things, if I can just refer to my students, is there are many different industries that require immediately you enter with an MBA. And that's great. And so they'll go right from a bachelor's degree to an MBA. But there are also industries that it would behoove the student to get some experience so that they can bring it back into the classroom. And that way they can contribute better to conversations. Their writing techniques and their research papers will be much stronger. So some of the programs that an MBA you would want to go immediately would be something like hospitality, finance, accounting, or even, the medical or criminal justice field. But then there are others such as marketing, the retail programs, social media programs that you want to go out, you want to understand what's going on, what's current in the industry, and then bring all of that information back into the classroom.
So are those industries that are more apt to pay for someone to go back to school, for instance, that marketing?
Actually, there's a lot of industries that will offer to, pay partial education. And of course, you have to maintain a certain GPA for the company to do that. But a lot of companies are saying, if you want to better yourself, one, that's going to be more advantageous to us because you're more knowledgeable, less training on our part. And so therefore, they will offer some type of compensation.
I must say that I totally agree. For those of you that know me, know that my academic endeavor was quite different, I guess you could say. I finished my undergrad at 19, and then by the time I was 22, I had two masters. And I went straight through school. I was out of school at 22 years old. I did that for a purpose, different, really wasn't professional. personal reasons. But when I went to go try to get a job, a real job, I was overqualified, but I had no experience. So it was a hard time for me to try to find a job that would look over the fact that I have an MBA at 22, but I don't have any work experience. And it was tough for me to do that. So I completely understand when you say, yes, get an undergrad in certain industries and fields, go ahead and continue your education immediately. But there's some that definitely require some job experience. And like I said before, you never know if that's really what you want to get into. So you might as well dabble a little bit on different fields and go back to school.
And you're right. And trying and doing internships and trying a certain occupation will really allow you to see if this is something that you want to do, because you will be doing this for a very long time.
And to tell you the truth, while I was in school, internships were the way that I figured out what I wanted to do and what I didn't want to do. My three degrees are in completely different fields. Originally, I wanted to go into law, which incorporated all three degrees, but that's the reason why I realized that I didn't want to go into one aspect. I wanted to go into a different one because of the three different internships that I had while I was in school. And I tell my sorority sisters all the time, and people that ask me, oh, what's your advice? How did you get it done? Internships is definitely the way to go. And speaking of internships, one of our viewers actually has a question for you. She wants to know, how can they get in touch with you so that they can get interns for their businesses?
Well, they can contact me directly at mstjean@jw.edu, and then I'll be happy to forward on their information to our experiential education department. Absolutely.
Well, thank you so very much for joining us.